Around the World with MS World. I'm Dr. Daniel Kantor. We're here at the Abilities Expo in DC Metro in December 2015. And I know for a lot of people, there's different things you do to pass the time. Some people try to do physical activity, some people read books. A lot of people out there are gamers. And that's why I'm so happy to be joined here by the founder and executive director of the AbleGamers Foundation, Mark Barley. So, Mark, what I want to understand is, what is the foundation? What is the AbleGamers Foundation, and how you came up with the idea?
Well, so the AbleGamers Foundation is a charitable organization that helps people with disabilities play video games. So we work with technology developers, you know, people that make the games that you see, to make sure that they're including the features that people with disabilities want. We work with hardware manufacturers to make sure that we can create maybe new, amazing ways to interact with the games, because, you know, sometimes a standard controller isn't going to work for someone. And then, you know, because sometimes this equipment can be one-off and handmade and can be fairly expensive, we do grants to allow people who really can't afford to get their own personal equipment, you know, into their homes. We were actually started, I'm a disabled veteran, but my disability doesn't really affect my gameplay. But my best friend from the sixth grade was diagnosed with multiple sclerosis in 2001. And as we were joining our adult lives, we were separating and she was starting her family and I was starting ours. We always used video games to stay connected. And one weekend, she didn't join into the game like I expected. So I called her and she said, "Oh, you know, I'm not going to play today." And she was really bummed and really kind of sad. And I said, "Why? What's going on?" And she goes, "Well, multiple sclerosis has decided that my mousing hand's not going to work today, so I'm not going to be able to play." And I was really bummed and really depressed because I looked forward to this Friday evening for, you know, years we've been doing this. And so I spent that Friday, instead of gaming, looking for stuff for her, because I was like, there's got to be something out there that can help her, you know, navigate the game space a little bit more. And we weren't really finding anything. So I'm a technologist and, you know, a person with disabilities, and she had this need. So we just decided to create it. So we created the AbleGamers Foundation because we thought, well, if we need it, probably other families need it as well.
And what have you learned in all this time that you've had the AbleGamers Foundation? What surprised you most about everything that you've been doing?
Well, I've got a couple of theories that I'm working on that surprised me most. I'm a person who was not born with a disability, but came with a disability later on. And most people, like Stephanie, who had multiple sclerosis, you know, you live your life and then all of a sudden you're diagnosed with this disorder. And I've noticed there's a difference between people who get a disability later in life and people that are born with a disability, and what their expectations are. And I think a lot of people who kind of have a disability later in life are much more demanding of continuing to do the things that they enjoyed before their disability. Well, I think, unfortunately, and it's something that we've really tried to, like, cast away, people that are born with a disability kind of sometimes accept limitations a little bit more, and we really try to work hard to be like, no, you don't have to accept that, let's keep going. So it's just, that's one of the things I've really learned that's been interesting, becoming a disability advocate.
Now, when you're working with the hardware manufacturers and the software manufacturers, have they been receptive to this idea of making their games more accessible, or have you seen a lot of roadblocks?
Well, I would think in the beginning we saw a lot of roadblocks because it sounded really scary and hard, you know, and the technology wasn't quite there yet 11 years ago. I mean, if you think 11 years ago, we were still, you know, Google wasn't even around, something that we take for granted every day. As the field of video games has matured, and as our message and where we're approaching game developers as friends trying to increase their market space, not, you know, looking for gotchas, we've created trust within our game space, and now they're coming to us before a title even becomes live and saying, like, "Hey, AbleGamers, here's what we're thinking about. What are we missing?" And gives us an opportunity to kind of help them, like, craft a better accessible features in their games before it even hits the shelf. 11 years ago, I would ask, "Hey, have you ever thought about how someone with disabilities would play your game?" And, like, the developer would run.
Well, I want to thank you so much for the work you do. You make life more accessible. You're really a
thank
true advocate in the true sense of the word.
Thank you
for joining us.